Now, we're in for another treat too, because this is kind of like, I hate to put it this way, but kind of like Women in Rock night tonight.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yes.
that's why we're glad you're here. And so we're going to ask Ziggy to bring on board by Skype Clare Cunningham from the band Thundermother.
Awesome.
Thundermother from Sweden. And they had a gig tonight, I think, and she stayed up late to talk to us live from Sweden. So we'll try and connect with her in a second. And then, Clare, hello.
Hi.
Hey, Clare.
Hello.
Well, let me tell you, you've got me. My stage name is Satan. And look at you. You look so good.
Me? Oh, God. I can't see you, but you can see me. Okay.
Yeah, we can. Yeah. It's good video. Now, co-hosting tonight is Ross Stitches Carpenter. She is bass guitarist for a band in Dallas called Designed in Chaos. So say hi to Ra, please.
Hi.
Hi, how are you?
Good. How about you?
I'm really good, thank you. It's nice and quiet because it's 2:45 here a.m. So everyone in the world is sleeping while I'm awake.
Well, we really appreciate you staying up late. We certainly do. And so,
oh, no worries.
Look, is it snowing outside?
Oh my God, is it? It is just covered outside in snow.
did you have a gig tonight?
Yeah, I had a solo show in town. So it finished really early, like 11. Normally it's 12:30, but on Sundays it's a little earlier to finish. So I've been threading through the snow back home.
Are you in Stockholm right now?
Yes, I'm currently in Stockholm now. So it's like -4, I think.
Wow.
So yeah.
So, yeah.
I'm gonna be in Dallas instead.
Yeah. Well, look, I'm not gonna ask you when you're touring in America. You probably get asked that all the time, okay? But suffice it to say, when you are able to come over, please spend a little extra time in Dallas, and we will show you around. And also, we've got some very cool music places, venues, and of course, we're the Assassination City. The greatest unsolved murder mystery in the world, you know, happened right here. So,
yeah, no, and it's actually one of the places I might actually go myself if I don't with the band to visit anyway in the summer, because I was in Texas actually this September. I was in Austin and Nashville, and oh, it's just amazing. And we, Thundermother, are dying to get to America. It is on the cards. It's just we're going to have to wait for the proper kind of support tour first.
Yes.
Because America isn't somewhere you can just go really on a whim or do a headlining tour. So we are hopefully in the process of sorting it. So we will get to you guys. And yes, thank you for that offer.
Man,
we'll definitely take you up on.
Yeah, good. And when you come to Texas, you can go. Then when you head back to Sweden, you're going to look like you have a suntan. You are. You are.
Well, I'm Irish, so I don't really tan anyway. But I can make believe. We can pretend.
It is so great to talk to you. So, all right, now here's the myth, and you correct me because I'm probably exaggerating, but that you got a call from Thundermother. You were in Ireland, there in Sweden. You got a call from Thundermother. This is a couple years back, and they said we want you to be our lead singer and our first gig. We're going to share the stage with Motorhead.
Yes, everything is right apart from I was actually in the UK at the time. So I'm originally from Ireland, but I was living in Wales. And yes, you're correct. I just had received a voicemail on my phone from a random girl called Philippa in Sweden. And of course, this wasn't a daily thing that I ever had. So I thought this was a bit strange. Literally, her voicemail had said, "Hey, my name is Philippa. I have a band. I'm in Sweden. We have some festivals this summer. And we came across you on YouTube and we'd love you to sing for us." So, of course, my initial reaction was, it's a bit strange. Luckily, I actually wasn't able to contact her back. So she contacted me. Thankfully, she was determined to speak to me. And she contacted me the following day. We spoke on the phone. I was in the car. I was just out of the gym, and I was talking to her, and I was telling her that, look, it's not really possible for me just to go over in, it was in 3 weeks as well. And I said, look, in that time scale, I have weddings booked in. I'm a singer. I was always a singer full time, and it was what I was doing at the time in the UK. And I said, these people have booked me years in advance, so I can't really turn around and kind of just cancel to do some festivals, you know. And I had no idea even it was an all girl lineup or anything. And then she hits me with it 15 minutes later. Well, look, have a think about it. We'll fly you over. We'll have you sorted. And because the thing is, we're actually opening up Metal Town in Gothenburg for Motorhead. And I was like, what? Where's my pen? Yep. Sign me up. So, yeah, long story short, basically, I went home, I checked out Thundermother. I was like, hell, these are good. These are actually really, really, you know, this is a decent band who've done a lot already. And it's all female as well. That's even cooler.
Yeah.
So those 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks, I literally just had phone recordings from Philippa because they didn't have anything, like they had no album recorded or anything, just a couple of songs. So it was just Philippa and her guitar, and she sent me lots of voice notes on the phone, and I just listened and listened. Flew me in the day before, met the girls. Hello. And then we went out on stage and opened up a festival. So, wow. Yeah, it is an awesome story. Like, a lot of people kind of like always wonder how we have all managed to get together. So that's my bit anyway.
Thundermother, and I'm going to ask our engineer to pull up maybe It's a Tease. What a great song and a great video. And yeah. I love them all. You've got some just some great pictures on your website as well, and all of that. You guys are just an inspiration, I'm sure, to a lot of rockers and a lot of girls who want to be rockers, and that's a, you know, big high fives to you.
Oh no, thank you. That really, it's nice to hear that as well. And yeah, I think you know, especially young girls, we like to target that kind of audience too, because, you know, it is a tough industry, and it's not one that's dominated by females in any shape or form. So we're hoping to just pave that way to help current situations be a bit more, you know, equality, etc., etc. And yes. Yeah, we do. We get a lot of great messages on a daily basis from people all over the world, saying how great it is. Actually, so funny, because we got one from the US yesterday. I just was on our fan mail and I was reading through a few,
yeah.
And some guy had said, I think, oh, actually, it might have been YouTube even. And he said, it's so sad that the US churns out artists such as Katy Perry and Taylor Swift and blah, blah, blah. You know, I have to go across to Europe to find you girls.
Yes.
So, yeah, you know, so rock and roll, you know, is still alive. And hopefully we're doing what we can. And yes, young girls especially, it's good to keep them kind of motivated as well too. Continue with it.
I describe your music as just kind of straightforward, you know, all out rock, just the way Lemmy would say it. He said, we're Motorhead and we play rock and roll, and that's you.
Yeah, and that's, we have a lot to thank for, because Lemmy was actually a fan, and he did always, because we had a good rapport with Motorhead and even their personal assistant, Victor. And, you know, he really did want us to go on tour with them, and I think that would have been the plan for 2017, if not before.
Yeah.
And, you know, rest in peace to the best rock god there was, you know.
Yeah.
So yes, straight up rock and roll. It doesn't, you know, 3-4 chords, that's all you need. And yeah, simple beats, and that's what we want to keep alive as well, you know, because there's the tendency sometimes to veer away and go a little more commercial, which, you know, we might do for a song or two, but
sure.
No, we're trying our best to keep gritty rock and roll alive.
Look, we as fans will totally understand if you make one album that's sort of mainstream and then go back to the good driving rock and roll. We're forgiving. Rock fans are okay with that. It's all right. Or maybe even just one song you push a sort
of. It would be more the likes of maybe one song or something, but it'll still be in rock. But we're gonna take the time now and spend the first half now of 2017 actually writing, and like we've already started, but
good for you.
We really want the creative time and space now to get a really awesome third album, which is gonna be more, I think we said we're gonna try and go back to the roots, more like the first album, Rock and Roll Disaster, and keep it more maybe blues rock and just straightforward rock and roll.
Speaking of that, let's talk about Clare Cunningham for a moment. Now, you've got a newly released, was it last month, EP, four-song EP, and you said you were playing a solo gig last night. I see your acoustic guitar behind you. So,
that's my little Martin. That's from my sister. My sister gave me that. She's actually in the States, Laura, and she knows that I travel a lot and I gig a lot, and I don't always, sometimes I leave my gear in venues, so I don't always have my guitar at home. Yeah. So she was kind enough to send me this little mini Martin for my practice purposes at home.
Yeah,
so
good.
That is just, my little quarter inch, I'm not quarter inch, to like a quarter size. I did. I released a solo EP, four tracks. It was actually exactly 1 month. Well, we're into Monday now with you guys and us. So to the 11th, it was the 11th of November. So, it's been going really, really good. I'm so happy with the results, and we'll get an album out as well next year as well. So
a Clare Cunningham solo album. Is that what you mean?
Yeah, exactly. Okay. So Thundermother will hopefully by the end of coming towards the end of next year, we'll have a product out, a third album, and I will also release my first solo album as well. And I work with a few different artists as well, and I'm doing like a hip hop trap kind of project at the minute as well. So it's all systems go for me, but it's all really good. So.
Well, when I listen to the four song EP, and I'm sharing this with Ra also, I got the impression that Clare would like to spend a day in Nashville. That was my thought.
And I did. I was there in September. I was there for 4 days, and it was the best. Oh, I'm a huge, huge, huge country blues fan. I did Austin for 5 days and Nashville for four. And honestly, it was the best trip of my entire life. Like, if I was only talking about it tonight as well, there's a guy was over from America, and I was doing he's doing a film documentary on female voices in rock and roll. And he was there tonight just at the show because he's still over. And I was just saying how much I adore America. Just if anybody wants to give me a green card, fine, I'm there.
Well, and your sister's here already, right?
She's in Nantucket Island, off in the East Coast. She's been there for a while. So I visit every year. I try and see a different part of America every year, and I visit her also. So she's nicely settled there, and it's gorgeous. It's so lovely over there, and just America in general. I absolutely adore you guys. And the plan I'd see myself living there. I'm hoping to do the move as soon as I can, but we'll see what happens.
Well, wow, that's great. And of course, when you're in Dallas, let us buy you around, or at least give you a tour of our city, our friendly city. And you hear a lot about Austin. You even mentioned Austin, but we feel we've got the entertainment capital of Texas right here. It's Deep Ellum, a music district of Dallas.
I'm not even lying to you, because I'm planning on going back to Nashville hopefully in the summer, and I've said to my friend, I have to make a trip to Dallas, because it's one of the ones that I have to tick off the list. So you might see me sooner than you hope.
Well, good. No, that's fine. And just please stay in touch with me and let me know when that happens. Hey,
yeah.
Look, and isn't Nashville inspiring? I mean, you've got all these studios, you got all these great musicians, right? And did you play gigs, or were you just recording, or what?
No, I just went by myself. I wanted to, it was the trip of a lifetime, like, for me, because I'm such a huge country blues fan and always have been and love America. So I turned the big 30 in the summer of this year. And as I just wanted to do something to commemorate.
Yeah.
And there wasn't really many people available just to come with me. So I thought, hey, you know what? I'm just going to go. So actually, my sister met me out in Nashville because she was meant to work in RCA Studios on Music Row in Nashville. So we got the private tour of the studios. So thanks to Eddie Gore for that.
Very nice.
It was awesome. It was so, so inspiring. And I think, you know, when we can get the girls out, I think it's going to be a lot of fun. I think we're going to really just eat it up.
Good. Hopefully. Good. So you live in Stockholm now?
I do. I'm in Stockholm. Based here. That's what I like to say, because I do so much traveling alone as well. So I'd say it's kind of like my main base is Stockholm. Yeah.
And did you grow up, here, obviously Irish music was all around you, obviously, right? And to me, Claire, and Ra, I mean, I want your opinion too. I mean, I think Irish music is the most passionate on the planet. And, you know, for you, you tear in your eye with a lilt, or you're moving your feet with an Irish jig. And it's just all just the greatest, in my opinion. And I don't think that there's a far leap from Dublin to Nashville in terms of sound. Do you?
No, you're hitting the nail on the head there for sure. And as a person who sings a lot of Irish music on a daily basis, because I sing in a lot of Irish bars, and nothing beats that feeling. I do a cappella numbers. There doesn't have to be any music.
Right.
And there's something so pure and special about the music that comes from home. Being biased or anything. But I get that as well with the American and the folk and country style, because it really comes from the heart, you know. People always get surprised, you know, when they think that rock is my favorite style. Of course, it's one of them. But my heart and soul has always lied within the Irish country folk, kind of the purity of it. I don't know. It's really hard to explain, you know, and you've said it yourself. It's like it just gives you the chills. And so many people have said it to me on many occasions, like, oh, you know, you just give us the goosebumps. And I'm like, well, a bit of reverb helps. And, you know, but there is, I don't know, it's and time and time and time and time again, I've never could grow old of singing those kind of songs and that style. And that's what I hope when I do an album as well. That 4-track EP was only really something like a quick taster, but I think my album is going to be a lot more country blues, kind of very Irish folk orientated, hopefully anyway.
But let's be clear to our viewers, our listeners, and that is that, you know, that Claire sings a powerhouse voice with Thundermother. And it, and obviously you're out on stage just belting it out, rocking, so if our engineer can pull up maybe a live YouTube or so. Hey, I wanted to mention to you also, we have a new sponsor, Claire, for our show, and guess what it is? It's called metaldating.com. And so it's like for metalheads who are single. And they want to find another metalhead, and I think it's worldwide.
Oh my god!
So we're gonna do a brief shout out right now to metaldating.com, metaldating.com. If you're single and you're into metal, check out that website. So There we go.
There you go. That's all the metalheads across the globe who want to date metalheads.
That's right.
Like, seriously, there's an app for everything nowadays, I swear.
And I think there's a niche dating site for everything these days.
Yeah, literally. I honestly joke around with some friends sometimes. I bet if we like looked up this would actually exist. And it does usually. So I think there's nothing Google has never been received like that, you know, that hasn't been said or done or created. So, yeah.
So the new album, Thundermother, is the latest album is Road Fever.
Yes, it is. Yes.
Yeah. Road Fever. It's Just a Tease is a song that has been stuck in my head, Clare. it's a tease. It is. Yeah, for 48 hours at least. What a great song. And the whole album is just engrossing. And, you know, I just want to encourage everyone to, I think there's a lot of people in America don't know about Thundermother. Okay. So, not yet. So, this show, I hope you remember us when you're big in America, because we want to springboard metalheads' knowledge and purchase of CDs of Thundermother.
Oh, well, thank you so much. And we always appreciate support, no matter where it comes from, big or small. Because, you know, I say this to all our fans every time we play shows as well. Like, people don't realize that because of the likes of you guys and the likes of the fans who come to shows and buy tickets, we can actually do and produce what we love to do. And in a society that says rock and roll is dead, well, we're hoping to prove that wrong. Okay. And it's amazing the support we do receive. And yeah, you're right. We're not so known in America. Like, we have a good handful of if not more, I mean, of great American fans and Canadian fans. But of course, it's a lot further away and we don't get so much promotion with you guys. So to do something like this is great and thank you. And also it's, you know, we're waiting for that right support tour and hopefully something comes along so that the burst in America can happen. Because I really, really firmly believe, you know, things are great in Europe here for us, of course, but I do believe we have a great market in America. Certain states more than others, of course, but the type of music that we do, you know, and we get asked a lot, when are you coming to America? And we have a lot of American true hardcore fans. So, yeah, hopefully, you know, through doing things like this with yourselves and magazines and getting airplay, you know, that we can build up enough hype and then hit the road and get to America.
Yes, Ra. So we want Thundermother to be part of the hard rock, heavy rock tribe, American tribe. We want you part of that. And so here's what I'm going to do. We like extreme metal here too, Clare. And so I'm going to give away a CD. It's not one of yours. I'm sorry. It's by a band called Tribulation. And so we're going to give away a CD by Tribulation, a black metal band. I think they might be from Sweden also.
A lot of music comes out of this country.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And this would be to the first person who emails in the title, and don't say it, Clare, the title of Thundermother's first album. You said it earlier, but don't say it again. The title of Thundermother's first album. Email me at stiltdemon@gmail.com. stiltdemon@gmail.com. And I'm going to give this to him. But they have to tell us correct answer. The name of Thundermother's first CD, right?
There you go.
Yeah. Okay.
So sealed for them.
Let's see if they know it. Hey.
If they were listening.
That's right. again, a big appreciation and hand claps to you for staying awake till 2:30 in the morning for us.
Well, listen, mate, that's no problem. I'll be awake till usually 6 anyway, so we can always, you know, American interviews suit me. Because I'm built to be there.
Yes, you are. That's right. Your body's time clock is already on American.
It's already on American time. It's perfect.
And Texas is calling you. You know, we're the home of ZZ Top.
I know. I love it. And, you know, we're big fans. Thundermother are big fans of ZZ Top. So, yeah. No, just amazing music and guys. And, you know, as a band, we have a lot of different artists we like separately. But ZZ Top are definitely among the ones that we love, all five of us, you know. So, yeah.
I want you to give a big thank you, and I'm serious now, to your band, because they were very friendly to me when I reached out to them. They were gracious. They were prompt, and I really did appreciate it. And then it was kind of like, all right, Clare, she's going to do it. So they put it all on you.
Well, we're very, very, very grateful to a great guy called Olivier, and he runs our fan page for us. And he recently was able to take over answering a lot of our mails, because especially when we're out on tour, we get a lot of mail come in, and the traffic of it gets very, very busy. And unfortunately, and even though we'd love to, we don't always get to promptly reply. And even though it doesn't go unmissed, of course. So we had a big discussion, and Olivier does a lot of the answering of our mails. And so he had contacted us all and said, hey, listen, I've got 3 interviews that need doing. So can you please see what suits you girls, etc.? And I saw, oh, Dallas. I was like, I can do that one, no problem.
Yes, good.
So, but anyway, usually the American ones usually I end up doing those ones anyway. Right. But it's always a pleasure anyway to do whatever. Right. But and thank you for saying that. I will pass on the good remarks to him and the girls.
Yes, indeed. Please do. And all right. So Ron and I were talking about this before. We want to know what is a secret talent you have? Is it maybe building a puzzle very quickly, or I don't know, mixing a drink or something? I don't know. We're just curious about Clare.
Ooh, a secret talent. I have never actually been asked this before. It wouldn't be very much a secret, would it, if I let you know?
we could call it a hidden talent.
A hidden
talent. Maybe you can stand on your hands or something. I'm just curious.
Oh, I wish I could. I'm one of these people who works out 6 days a week, and I see girls who never hit the gym or never work out, and they can do it.
Yeah.
And I still can't. And that really annoys me.
Look,
I haven't got good wrists. Clearly. Hidden talent.
While you're thinking.
I can Irish dance, but that's not really a hidden one, because whenever we're anywhere, the girls always get me to do that. And so I happily, people have seen me Irish dance.
Well, while you're thinking about that, can I ask this? Look, your EP release party, okay? And I found these pictures, and it looks like. Looks like there was a burlesque show. Was there a burlesque show at your.
Yeah, there was. It was so much fun. So basically, one of the tracks on the EP called Temporary Lover was actually written by, it's the only one I didn't write, and it was written by Caesar, my boss at the label that I'm signed with, Low Medium High Records. And basically,
Clare, is that you wearing the tie and the, it looks like, that's you.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not the one that's naked in those photos. It's the other ones, because there's like people were like, was that you on the stage?
Yeah,
I was like, no, wasn't me. So the burlesque dancer, Lady Francesca, she did an actual live burlesque performance of that song, Temporary Lover.
Nice. Now,
so, yeah, it was cool. It's really cool.
Very good. And we're looking at a few of those pictures right now on our screen. Very, very cool. Is there a lot of burlesque in Stockholm?
I don't think so, because I'm not one to go to burlesque stuff. So to me, that was my first time ever being in there. Actually, it used to be an old rock bar, somebody had said to me. So I don't think I don't think it's such a popular thing. It's not like it's a whole row of burlesque venues or anything like that. It's one of a few, I think. So no, it's not. And people were like, they were a bit like, you know, confused as to why. But yeah, it was my label that had already pre-organized the night. And we decided to make it into my release night as well. And because the performance of Temporary Lover, the song that I have on my EP, was being performed by this burlesque dancer, we decided to coincide the whole thing. So that's how I ended up having it there.
That is a great story. It looks like a great party. And Clare, I want to be invited to your next release party. I will try to make sure my passport is up to date.
Yeah, do it, because I think we'll have a lot of fun. For sure.
Now,
and I'm sure us as the band, I'm sure Thundermother, when we have an album released and out, we'll have to have some form of release party too, so
good,
you can hit two birds with one stone.
Sure. Or at least come back on our show and let's talk about your new album or forthcoming album or tour. We'd love to have you back if you don't mind staying in touch with the Corpsepaint Show.
No problemo. It'd be my pleasure.
Now, how do people buy your new EP? Do you want to do, should we direct them to your Facebook page? What do you prefer?
Absolutely, yeah, it's probably best. I'm all over the social media, so you can buy it online. And actually, I think it's already in dollars. You see, there
Great.
You go, it's already set in dollars for you guys. Yeah, if you go onto my Facebook, which is my full name, Clare Cunningham, Clare Cunningham. Yeah, all the links are there for everybody in the About section on my Like page, and on Instagram, Clare C Official, Twitter, Clare C Official as well. So you can get, it's all the info's there. And if anybody has any trouble finding it, I can send you the links as well via email, and they can contact the station and absolutely get it via there. So they can. And with the Thundermother stuff, I just know that you can get that anywhere. I think on iTunes, Google Play. Same with my EP as well. It's all over Spotify and Google and iTunes and stuff like that. And physical copies, yeah, you can buy with our record label, Despots Records. So, yeah, everything is online in the online world.
Yes,
thankfully.
Good. I went to Spotify and played your EP, and then it stayed on my iPad. And Clare, you just kept singing to me all day, and I'm like, "Well, Clare is here already. She's just all day long. She's singing to me."
So,
yeah, and so I guess there's something on Spotify I don't know how to do yet, and that is like rotate to the next artist or something. So
yeah, I know it's you have to get your head around it, but I think you can also with Spotify, what's really awesome, and I find a lot of especially new American country artists this way, by going to Artist Radio. And then it will play similar artists to the artists that you're listening to. But I went to a music seminar with my management team, Infrasound, not so long ago. And it was to do with Spotify. And it was really interesting. It was a startup thing. And there was the main founder or the organizer, you know, because being in Sweden, she was talking about the different statistics that they have in the database. And, you know, the more things that you listen to, the more that Spotify is going to feed you with music that you listen to. So they do an analytic kind of, you know, database based on what you listen to. So it's all very cleverly done and created. But if you're looking to listen to like, yeah, different similar artists, I think you can just go to like Artist Radio or something, and then it will kind of play the artists that you're listening to, but similar ones as well. So yeah. There you go.
Very cool. Very cool. Yeah. Anything else that we want to, because Clare, we want to have you on again soon, if at all possible. Let's stay in touch.
Yeah, sure.
I really do appreciate the time.
No problem.
You know, I am always curious, like, what it's like in the studio. And is that, you know, are you in the studio after, you can answer this too, but after you've written the songs, or you just kind of have a rough idea on a song? I don't know.
We write it together as a band. So
you jam it in the studio sometimes, so, is where it comes to.
Yeah, okay. And sometimes we write all the synths first and then go back and fill in with bass and guitar and stuff.
Cool. All the flair.
Yes.
All the good stuff.
Clare, well, we love that.
For us, we're not really the typical band that have ever had the opportunity to write in the studio, because when we did our first album, which I'm not allowed to say the name because it's competition, I was in the UK and then the other girls were spread across Sweden as well. So it was recorded in four different studios. And then it all was given to the mix. So it was kind of like a bit more difficult to get us all in the same country.
Right.
Second album, we did a little bit. We were all in the one country, but we all had, you know, different things to be doing. So we had everything written in advance. So this time round, you know, unless you have the luxury of having a studio to your disposal,
sure,
it's time is money in studio, you know, and so it doesn't always, a lot of things can be written spur of the moment and sound good, and that's what we like, you know.
Good.
It can happen in the studio too, but we tend to have the finished product, almost finished product going into the studio to record.
Gotcha.
Because it's just, it saves a lot of time for us as well. And, you know, it's straightforward classic rock and roll. So, you know, there's not so much making up on the spot to be done, like with different styles. Sometimes people find the right better in studio, but we tend to do it better when we've kind of at least tried it a few times, rehearsed it, and then just get in and get the tapes rolling.
Yeah, good. Clare Cunningham from Stockholm, we give you a big hails and cheer and smiley faces and hand claps and Thundermother, and also her solo EP, Clare Cunningham. Look for it. We'd love to talk again with you. And as you get closer to coming across the pond, please stay in touch, Clare.
Sure.
So, and again, big thanks to your band and yourself and the dude who handles all of the fan mail. So.
Yeah, so. I'll give him a personal shout out. No problem. Thank you guys for having me, taking the time, and for supporting rock and roll, because we really, really do appreciate it. And to all the listeners, to everybody who continues to buy records, come to concerts, you know, it doesn't go unnoticed. We really, truly, and thankfully, you know, we're so thankful, and we're so grateful to you all. So thank you.
If you like straightforward rock and roll, you got to check out Thundermother. Right, Ron?
Right.
Yes.
Definitely.
Thank you again, Clare. We're gonna sign off, and if you don't mind, I'll stay in touch with you.
Yes, sure, no problem.
All right, speak to you later.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Wow, cool. And she had a gig tonight too.
Yeah.
And so she released her EP with a burlesque party.
That was really cool.
All right, so we're gonna play a little game now, Ron.
Okay.
It's called Margin of Terror.
Okay.
Margin of Terror. And so what we do is we have a whole bunch of black metal band spiky logos.
Okay.
That I'm going to show you.
All right.
See if you can guess the name of the band.
Oh, no.
Yeah. And some are easy and some are not so easy.
Okay.
And so as you can see, we support black metal from all over the world, and straightforward rock, heavy rock, and extreme punk and industrial and all of it. Designed in Chaos 2. Yes. And so we got our Brazil front flag and UK and Sweden, Norway. All right, so this one, I don't remember the name of this one. Are you able to see it okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, there we go. Thank you, Ziggy. So our engineer tonight is Ziggy, and he's got this on the screen. And Oh man, I gotta look up the name of that. I wrote them down separately, and I'm not. You want to take a guess?
We the devil. Something dual.
Red.
There's a D.
Red veil. I don't know. Hell.
Hold on. Let me just look. Let me just check it.
Let's scroll to the next one too, and so I know there's a couple easy ones in there.
So okay. I can make out Carnage.
Perpetual Carnage, maybe.
Yeah, Carnage, and is it?
I don't know.
Pestilential. I think that's it. Pestilential. Carnage.
Holy shit, that is it.
Yeah, okay. So in Margin of Terror, I think Ziggy's got one.
All right.
And I think you almost got one too. So all right. And all right. Now this one is not Absu. Is it Krieg or no? Creel?
Creel. Well, it looks like Creel. I don't know.
This is Kill Krill.
That's a good guess. All right, let's do the next one. Oh, yeah. That looks like a whole bunch of sharp knives.
Yeah, I don't know.
That is the band formerly known by a name.
Yes. Okay, so in the black metal world, we need to be able to understand their spiky logos. So, we got to get these. Okay. All right. This one we talked about earlier.
This one's an easy one.
The first part is demon.
Demon? I don't know.
Go ahead, Ziggy.
Demontuary?
Demontuary.
Demontuary.
Like demon and mortuary?
Yes. Exactly. Speaking of mortuary, we have our dead friend over in the other seat. Ziggy, we need a name for that girl/androgynous person over there. Who actually has no clothes on.
Sergeant Peepers?
Hold on, let me come around. Can I grab the... Leave it on that.
Yeah.
Leave it on that.
I'm just walking around here. Get it close.
We need a name for this person. Is that good?
Yeah.
All right. Next one. All right. What do you see, Ra?
It's the
one at on the top. Yeah, it's like morbid. Not the word. Yeah, not the word on the bottom, but
morbid. I don't know.
my scar, my
mithril, maybe. like maybe they're like a fantasy like that.
It could be. Yeah, mithril. But look, we have to strike the pose like they're doing it.
Okay.
All right, Ziggy, you got some more?
Yeah.
We got some easy ones here. We got easy ones.
Okay. This one here.
This is easy, Ra. The first word is the.
It looks like the cruel.
The cruel.
The cruel.
Yeah, the cruel.
I'm really bad at reading these.
But I like the imagery. I like the imagery too because you know it's like demon grabbing the severed head, and we have that head right over there.
Awesome.
All right, and we have
cruel.
One more.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
So that's as zoomed in as I can get it, and you know, free for all. Go for it.
Yeah, I've got these written down. I'm going to have to, like, yeah.
That's not a font.
No, that is. That's a font. That is black metal. I will find him. I will find him.
I see an A, an O, and an S, I think, right there.
I don't even...
You have to train your eyes.
Like this line is the top rather than the bottom of the notebook line. And so like these are the tops of the letters. Like there's kind of an A.
Okay.
And then there's like... an O in that general area.
Okay. Look, let's do this. We're going to play a bit of a video. Is that okay, Ziggy? From Thundermother. I would prefer to do It's a Tease. It's a Tease, or anyone you've got queued up.
I have the official It's a Tease video.
Yeah, let's play a little bit of that. I do want to say thank you to Bulldog and Danny, who are in the studio. What a great show you guys had with Scary Cherry and the Bang Bangs. And for all our viewers and listeners, always check out the Bulldog and Danny show. What a great show tonight, guys. You had the whole band in here. That was so cool.
All right, if you're ready.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's do it. Thundermother, It's Just a Tease. That is their single off their most recent release called Road Fever.